Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton and we're gonna do it. I'm going to update. I know it's been 2 years since I've done my list of favorite plugins. I'm gonna give you 10, maybe a few more here and there, of my favorite WordPress plugins for 2016. Here we go. I've got to start off, you know, this one is it. Everybody knows about Yoast. It's my favorite still to this day SEO plugin. So if you're not using that, please look at this one. Be sure that you're using this specifically for search engine optimization. There's all sorts of tutorials on how to use this plugin, and we've done a whole series here on our YouTube channel as well on how to use Yoast for your WordPress website. Check that one out. All right, next on my list, of course, is Gravity Forms. Now, this is a premium form builder program. So if you want a contact form on your website, this is a really great program to use. It does a heck of a lot more, though, than just contact forms. And we have another whole series I've done on this plugin. I'll put all these links in the description box below so you can check these out and really truly understand the value that you get with paying for a premium plugin like Gravity Forms. If you needed a free option, though, Contact Form 7 is probably still my favorite free form building plugin. Gravity Forms, though, by far outweighs what the capabilities are inside of it and just is all around a fantastic form builder program. All right, if you're looking to do a gallery on your website, a photo gallery, Foo Gallery has really surpassed a lot of the other options on the market right now. I think it's outstanding. You can see the reviews here. A lot of people are feeling the same thing about it. Super easy to use, highly flexible, fully responsive, of course, and has a really slick light box that opens these images up. Really super nice option here. So check out Foo Gallery. Again, all these links are going to be in the description box below. If by chance, though, you're interested in having kind of a hands-off scenario when it comes to adding photos to your website, and you're really, really active on the social network called Instagram, and you're taking a lot of pictures from your phone and you're uploading things, and you would like, hopefully, those images to appear on your website as well. Good for search engine optimization because that's fresh content. Easy for you because it's just straight from your phone and you don't necessarily have to log in your website. You can use a plugin called the Instagram feed. It's really spectacular. Shows you some cool stuff of how your Instagram feed could look on your website with really cool different displays. Again, fully responsive. Really, really nice. They can click to load more on a page. They can click on an image and pop over to your Instagram account. And of course, you would be gaining followers on your Instagram account if you're using this pretty awesome plugin. So check that one out. All right. This is like number 4, but I've already given you too many, so I'm losing track. So let's just keep going. Google Places reviews. If you're utilizing Google Plus for any of your reviews, be sure to not send people away to go read your reviews. Have your reviews listed on your website directly. So if you watch this video, it'll walk you through very quickly what it looks like to have these reviews appear on your website. It's a widgetized thing that you just drag the widget over, put it in the sidebar or the footer area that you'd like it to appear in. You have a couple of different options on the theme layout, the design of the different layouts of how your reviews can appear in your website. And I mean, for free, it's really spectacular. There's a pro version of it, but the free version is pretty spectacular as well. So check that out if you're interested in bringing over and bragging, or letting your customers rather brag about your awesome services on your website. Let's talk about backing up your website. It's super important that you always have a backup in place, especially before you do any updates. So you want to have an option in your website that is consistently backing up your website and giving you the option to restore it in case anything goes wonkadoo and you're able to click restore my website, fix it, please. I don't want it to be broken or to have any downtime. If you're using Updraft Plus, this is a free plugin. The free version, it does have a paid version, but the free version is pretty spectacular as well. It allows you to set in place an automatic backup, and the restoration process in this particular plugin is totally free. So one click to restore it back. All right, let's talk about something you might not know about. I've mentioned MailMunch before. This is the program that we use on WebTegrity's website to gather subscribers, and we got the idea from a guy, WP Dev Solutions here in town, Wayne. We'll give a shout out to him. If you're interested in grabbing more leads, though, and getting people to subscribe to your blog, this is a really non-intrusive, really great way of having people sign up to your website. I'm telling you right now, our web list has just grown out of nowhere from us installing this. It's a free installation, it's a free program up to a certain point, and then you have paid options. But if free is in your budget, and it should be, check this out to grow your email list. It's pretty spectacular. Let's talk about blogging. If you've got a featured image that you're using and you're frustrated that it always appears kind of in a wonky way inside the post and you just don't want it to always appear there, you want to be able to kind of dictate where it ends up in the post, this particular plugin solves that problem. It allows you to have a secondary field that when you choose to add a featured image, it will appear, you know, in your thumbnail view. But if you don't want it to appear large inside the post, this will give you the option to hide that featured image. So it's a really cool little tricky workaround, but sometimes you want to be able to hide some and then reveal some. So this is a cool one. And then the last one I want to walk you through is What the File. So this isn't the last one. I have one more after this. But What the File, this one is for all of you nerds who want to go crazy deep into development. And y'all want to figure out what PHP file or what exact file is manipulating the area on the website that you want to change or affect. So if you're a nerd coder that wants to go a little bit more advanced inside of WordPress, check out What the File and see what it can do when you install it into your dashboard. It's pretty spectacular. Let's look at responsive menus. If you want an option to have the hamburger icon, I'll show you one quick example here of a hamburger icon. If you want to have a menu that's fully responsive, so it looks like this on a cell phone, when you click on it, it slides out really nice. This is a plugin that is free for you to use. It does have a pro version, but the free version is pretty spectacular. It gives you a lot of opportunities to change the color, to change the kind of look and the feel, the styling of the menu. You can tell it to appear only in cell phone mode and kind of give it that breaking point. So this is a really cool feature. If maybe your theme options are a little off, or maybe your theme, the responsive menu on the theme you just don't like and you want some more control over it, this would be a really great plugin to use. All right, this is my last one I want to tell you about, EasyWP SMTP. This is specifically for sending emails through your website. A lot of times people complain that when they're using a form builder like Contact Form 7 or even Gravity Forms, people are not receiving the autoresponders, or perhaps even you as the business owner, you're not getting those leads and you don't know what's happening and the form is working correctly and sometimes you get a lead and sometimes you don't. That could actually be an issue with your mail server. So using a plugin like this allows you to kind of adjust your settings to redirect your mails. You can see here it sends all outgoing mails through a specific SMTP account that you can allocate. So that sounds a little bit more advanced, but walk through the instructions on this. It's actually very easy to follow, and it might fix the problem of you missing leads or your customers missing that communication with you. That was quick, and I think I gave you like 12 cool plugins. Well, check them out. If you have time, give them a shout out. Let them know that you found out about them over at the WebTegrity YouTube channel. Be sure to find us over on Twitter, too. If you're interested in any more tutorials like this or you have a question about one of these plugins, check with the plugin author first. See if they have some instructions in the installation panel. See if they have some FAQs or support area that you can even go to get some questions answered there. But if you absolutely can't find help, please be sure to put that in the comment box below, and we'll do our best to try to answer some of your questions. Always best practices, let me say this, always best practices when you're looking at YouTube videos. Be sure to defer to the fact of what sort of reviews every plugin that we're talking about, or theme for that matter, anybody making a YouTube video. Be sure that you look at the ratings, because this video could be a little out of date depending upon when you're watching it. Be sure to look at what version of WordPress it is compatible with. Be sure that you're running that. It's going to say what it's required to have, okay? And you always want to just be sure that you're hopefully running no more than 12 plugins. That's not a rule. That's my personal opinion. You could struggle with starting to see a website slow down or potentially have some conflicts in code as you add on and add on and add on all of these plugins. So be sure you're running a lean, fast-loading, easy-to-navigate WordPress website, and I hope it's super successful for you. If you have any questions, though, this is WordPress Wednesday. Every Wednesday, this is what I'm doing. I'm hanging out here on YouTube with you. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.